Hi everyone, welcome back. In this video, I'm going to share about the first tactile painting I did and the raw materials required to create one. To give you all a background, I was a late blind and I was into pencil sketching when I had my eyesight. I used to enjoy it, but after my blindness, I never thought I would be able to get back to artwork. But in 2018, I had been to a painting gallery wherein I not really experienced those two-dimensional paintings, and that's when I thought of creating tactile paintings that persons with vision loss like me could enjoy it and also do it themselves. The first tactile painting I did is called Happy Blossoms. It's a painting of four big yellow flowers on a blue background. So when the idea of this painting came to my mind, I was thinking of what material I can use to make it three-dimensional. So I'm going to share about how I created this painting now. First, I took a canvas and painted it blue. Of course, I took the help of the people around me for their feedback to see if I have painted the canvas without leaving any gaps in between. Second, I took a smaller size cellophane tape or a transparent tape and put it flat on the canvas so that, you know, there's a rounded hole on the canvas in between the roll of the tape. I then applied white glue in between that gap and I put golden beads on it, pressed them properly so that they are settled well, and then I removed the cello tape. I created four circles like this on the canvas, giving a bit of space between each other. Then I took some dry leaves from the garden, painted them yellow, and I glued them around these four beaded circles on the canvas. So that's how I created my first tactile painting. Now let's look at the basic raw material that we require to make a tactile painting. To start with, acrylic paints. Go for the student purpose ones as we are just learning. Second, canvas. You can start off with a smaller size ones, and maybe once you're confident about, you know, painting, then you can go for the bigger size ones. Brushes. So get brushes of different sizes, both square and round ones. A palette or a disposable plate for colors. White glue and super glue. Garbage bag, sellotape or transparent tape, and a masking tape. I used them for masking. As I'm still exploring it, I may just be using the masking tape once I figure out a feasible method to paint. Aluminum foil. This is the most important material in your tactile painting because you create the 3D objects using the aluminum foil. Next is blank papers. You will be using it to glue on the 3D aluminium objects and then paint over them later. Last are a hand cloth and a cup of water. So these are the things required to create tactile paintings. I hope the next time you will be ready with them so that we can start painting. So good luck. We'll see you all next time. Bye.
Is anybody still there? I'm not in this video at all, but I just wanted to say hi and leave you with a picture of Ash sticking her tongue out.